Okay, good morning students. Some of people is taking rest, I think Sunday fever. Okay, Lakshmi, you can start today. Lakshmi going to discuss on different insect pests of cotton. Okay, one of the important topic for your examination point of view. Okay, Amma, you continue.
Okay. Okay. So, good morning everyone. So today we are going to discuss about the cotton pest. So the screen is not changing. So the cotton pests are mainly categorized into three types. First one is the sucking pest that pierces plants with slender, sharp-pointed mouth parts, and it will also suck the plant sap. So withdrawal of this plant sap result in minute white, brown, or red spotting on wherever they attack. So the leaf hopper, aphid, thrips, whitefly, mealybug, red cotton bug, and dusky cotton bug comes under this sucking pest. Next is the borers. These are the pests that make a hole in whichever plant part they attack, and they will feed or lay eggs so that the emerging larvae will feed on the inner content. And the spotted bollworm, American bollworm, pink bollworm, stem weevil, and shoot weevil, it comes under the borer category. Next is the defoliator. So the insect that consumes leaves are classified as defoliators, and they are indicated by chewed, mined, or missing foliages. And in cotton, tobacco caterpillar, ash weevil, and leaf roller, it comes under defoliators. So next, let's see the detailed explanation of all the pests one by one. First is the cotton whitefly. The scientific name is Bemisia tabaci, and it comes under the family Aleroidae and order Hemiptera. So beside cotton, these pests also feed on hollyhock, lady's finger, tobacco, safflower, Acaranthus aspera, lablab, niger, and tapioca. So once these pests attack the crop, you can observe chlorotic spots on the leaves, which will later coalesce, forming irregular yellowing of leaf tissue, which will extend from veins to the outer edges of the leaves. And also when there is severe infestation, it will result in premature defoliation. And you can also notice the development of sooty mould due to the secretion of the honeydew by the whitefly. So most of the Hemiptera, Homoptera, they will secrete this honeydew. So due to the sucking of plant sap, there will be shedding of buds and balls, and also there will be poor bowl opening. So this is also a potential vector that transmits the leaf curl virus disease of cotton. So next is the biology of this insect. So the egg of this pest will be lightish yellow in the beginning, but later on it will turn into brown in color. And the egg period ranges from 3 to 33 days. And after the nymph emerges, it will be greenish yellow in color, and also they will be oval shaped. So here you can see in the right side top, it is oval shaped, scale like, and also there will be marginal bristle like fringes. Then the nymphs remain stationary once they settle down. And the nymphs will also molt about 3 times, and their period lasts for 9 to 18 days. And the pupa, it will also be oval in shape, and it present on the undersurface of the leaves. So this fly is a minute insect with yellow body, and their body is covered with a white waxy bloom. It is a peculiar characteristic of whitefly. They measure about 0.5 mm in length, and also they have white or grayish wings. And their body will be yellow in color, and they also have a red medially constructed eyes. So here in the right side down, bottom, you can see they are having a red color eyes. And a single female of the species lays about 70 stalked eggs. They will be having stalked eggs singly on the undersurface of the leaves, and mostly on the top or middle leaves of plant. They will prefer top and middle. Then the insect can often breed parthenogenetically, that is asexually. So there are about a dozen overlapping generations. So as I said, it is multi-volatile insect. Next, let's see the management strategies that are adopted for this pest one by one. First, it is the conservation of a chalcid parasite that attack the older nymphs, and the parasitization will be like 30 times more, 30% more. Also, there are a few predators like some species of Chrysopa and coccinellid, which feed on the whitefly. And also, we can grow tolerant varieties such as Kanjana, LK861, NA1280, which is also very effective against this whitefly damage. In order to reduce the incidence, we also have to avoid the alternate or cultivated host crop of the whitefly, as I mentioned above, in the vicinity of cotton crop. Next, growing cotton only once a year, either in winter or summer season in any cotton tract, to avoid the continuous supply of food to the pest. So next is the crop rotation should be adopted with the non-preferred hosts such as sorghum, ragi, maize, etc. for the whitefly to check the buildup of the pest. So next is the removal and destruction of alternate weed hosts like Abutilon indicum, Solanum nigrum. Then the timely sowing is also very much important with the recommended spacing. Preferably, the wider spacing should be adopted. And we have to avoid late sowing since the crop growth should not be extended beyond its normal duration. And we also have to use judicious application of nitrogen. And the irrigation management is also essential in order to arrest the excessive vegetative growth and also to avoid the pest buildup. Next is field sanitation. Whatever pest it is, field sanitation is very important and have to be given proper attention. So next is monitoring the activities of the adult whiteflies by setting up yellow pan traps and sticky trap. So the first picture is the sticky trap and the second one, it is a yellow pan trap at 1 feet height above the plant canopy. Then, as I said, the whitefly infested leaves from the plants and those should be collected and it should be removed. Then we can also spray any one of the following insecticides. While you are referring or if they ask
you, any... Amir, getting cut, ma'am.
Excuse me? Okay. If they ask in any exam, we should make sure that the recommended pesticide should be in use currently and not banned. So the following pesticides can be used. So next is you can spray any one of the following plant products alone or in combination with the recommended dose of insecticide like neem seed kernel 5%. Then you can use fish oil rosin soap 25 kg at 1 kg in 40 liter of water. You can also use nocci leaves 5% extract, and also Cantharanthus rosea you can use, which is also available at 5%. Next, you can, as a biological control, you can use white halofungus verticillium lecani, 1.15% vegetable powder at the rate of 2,500 gram per hectare. So next pest is the cotton aphid. The scientific name is Aphis gossypii. It comes under the family Aphididae and order Hemiptera. So here, besides cotton, it also feed on ladyfinger, brinjal, guava, and gingerly. Here, both the nymphs and adult, they both suck the sap under the leaf, and they cause the damage symptom like upward curling, then stunted growth you can observe, and also the plant will gradually die. And also the black sooty mold develops on the honeydew secretion of this aphid, which will fall on the leaves. So here, the adult, they will be small, soft, yellowish green or greenish brown in color. So you can also observe colonies of hundreds on the tender shoot and the undersurface of tender leaves. They are characterized by the presence of cornicles. It is a tube-like structure on the abdomen of this aphid. They are wingless normally, but wing form are often found mostly in the beginning and towards the end of the season. So the wings will be very thin and transparent, and also they are held like a roof over the body. So they produce both sexually as well as parthenogenetically, based on the temperature. And this parthenogenetic female, that is, when the aphids reproduce asexually, they will give rise to females oviviparously. Then the nymphs will be like light yellowish in color or brownish, and also they will be greenish black in color. They colonize around the growing points and the lower surface of the leaves, and also in the tender shoots. There are four instars. And the nymphal period will be about 7 to 9 days. And as I said, both the nymphs and adults will suck the sap by remaining on the lower surface of the leaf. So next is the management. So ETL of this pest is 15% of infested plant. So it is mandatory to conserve the coccinella beetles like Chelonomus sex maculata and Coccinella septopunctata. We can also release eggs or first instar larvae of Chrysoperla at 10,000 per hectare. Then we can go for seed treatment with imidacloprid. Then also in order to keep the crop free from sucking pest for over a month. Or we can also treat the seed with the thiomethoxam. Then you can spray the botanical insecticide like a neem seed kernel 5% or the insecticide clothianidin, imidacloprid or acetamiprid, and also thiomethoxam. These all comes under the neonicotinoid group of insecticide. And for smells, stem smearing, you can use imidacloprid with water mixture on the shoot tips for about 1 inch, and also 30 to 40 ml insecticide per acre is required at early stage of the crop, since these sucking pests usually attack the crop at early stage. So next is cotton leaf hopper. So besides cotton, it also attacks okra, eggplant, castor, cucurbits, hollyhock, potato, sunflower, and many other malvaceous plants. So here both the nymphs and adults, they suck the cell sap from the leaves, and they are also known to inject toxic saliva into the plant tissues. And as a result, the affected leaves turn yellowish and they will curl downwards. In case of heavy infestation, the leaves turn dark brick red and becomes brittle and crumpled. So next is the biology of this insect. The eggs will be pear shaped. The eggs will be very, very small, and it will be like a pear shaped, elongated, and will be yellowish white in color. And the period lasts for about 4 to 10 days. The nymphs are whitish pale color, and they are wingless. This nymphal period lasts for 7 to 21 days. And here you can see the adult, they are wedge shaped. They will be about 2 to 3 mm long and pale green in color with a black dot on posterior portion of each forewing. And also the adult of winter generation will be slightly reddish in color. And the adult can live up to 5 to 8 weeks, and a single female can lay up to 15 to 30 eggs. So next is the management strategy. So the ETL of this pest is 50 nymphs or adults per 50 leaf. That is 1 or 2 adults or nymphs per leaf. So the management strategy, you can adopt plant resistant or tolerant varieties like 603 Saita, then L64 Narasimha, and all those plants you can use as resistant varieties. Then you have to avoid late sowing. Then seed treatment with imidacloprid can be given in order to give protection up to 40 to 50 days after sowing. Then you can also apply soil application with carbofuron at the time of sowing at the rate of 1 kg per hectare. So wherever the leafhopper is a big menace or it's a big problem, you can also go for neem oil application or neem oil thrice at fortnight intervals. Then the coccinella beetles like Chelonomus sex maculata and Coccinella septopunctata, which are the predators of this particular pest, you can conserve the predators in the field. And also you can release eggs or first instar larva of green lace wing, that is Chrysoperla, at 10,000 per hectare. Then you can spray any one of the following insecticide as per the norm. Then you can also spray botanical insecticide. That is, botanical spray can also be practiced with the spraying of NSKE, that is a neem seed kernel, at the rate of 25 kg per hectare. So next is the cotton thrips, that is thrips tabaci or scriptothrips dorsalis. It comes under the family Thripidae and the order Thysanoptera. So it can also feed on onion, leek and garlic, brassicaceous plants such as cabbage, cauliflower and broccoli, then asparagus, sugar beet, melon, pumpkin, cucumber, strawberry, potato, tobacco, corn, and many other fruiting. It is a polyphagous pest. It can feed on many fruiting and ornamental plants. So next, let's move on to the damage. So once this pest affects the field and the crop, you can observe shriveling of leaves due to the scraping of epidermis, and also they will desap the plant content, and you can also observe that the terminal bulbs will be having ragged edges, and also you can observe silvery shine on the undersurface of the leaf. So the symptom you can mostly observe at the undersurface, because these pests will be coalesced or they are gathered in the undersurface of the leaves. Then the margins of the leaves will also be affected. The leaves get very slightly curled up, and the leaf blades will show uneven surface when it is attacked. And it occurs during flowering stage, and the affected plants may also wither away due to the sucking of the plant sap. So next is the biology of the insect. So the female, they insert their saw-like ovipositor into the plant tissue and lay her eggs under the epidermis. So the egg will be like first white in color, then they will turn orange, and it will hatch in 4 or 5 days. The larvae will be white or yellowish, and it will suck the sap from the plant tissues. There will be 2 larval stages, which will last for about 9 days in total, that are followed by the non-feeding prepupal and pupal stages. And these 2 stages will last for about 4 to 7 days in total. And also the adult, it survives for only 2 to 3 weeks, during which the female will lay about 80 eggs, and most of the eggs will be unfertilized and produced by parthenogenesis. And the onion thrips, it is also a vector of certain plant viruses like iris yellow spot virus, then strawberry necrotic shock virus, then tobacco streak virus, and also tomato spotted wilt virus. And also it is a vector of fungal disease, that is Alternaria pori. It is also known as purple blotch. So next is the management. The ETL is 50 nymphs or adults per 50 leaves. So most of the sucking pests, the management will be almost same. So here also you have to avoid the late sowing of the crop. Then you have to grow cowpea, onion, soybean, and as an intercrop in cotton in order to reduce the early stage pest. Then you have to go for deep plowing in summer, and the field should be free of weeds and surroundings. Surrounding should also be free of weeds. Then you have to release Trichogramma chylonis, 1.5 lakh per hectare. It is an egg parasitoid, and then you can also release Chrysoperla grubs, 1 to 2 per plants. Then you can go for seed treatment with imidacloprid, which will protect the crop from aphids, leafhoppers, and even thrips also up to 8 weeks. Then you have to spray any one of the insecticide like imidacloprid, methyl dimetone, dimethoate, and also you can spray NSKE at 2 kg per hectare. So next is the mealybug. It is a minor pest of this cotton, and the scientific name is Phoenicoccus solanopsis. They may ask the scientific name, or they may also ask the family, which comes under Pseudococcidae. So they also feed on brinjal, okra, tomato, sesame, sunflower, and China rose. So the damage symptom you can observe when the attack is crinkled or twisted leaves, you can observe. Then the leaves will be unopened, then distorted bushy shoots you can observe. Then on buds there will be a white fluffy mass, not only on buds, in stems, fruits and roots, everywhere you can observe this. And you can also observe presence of honeydew. As in any homoptera, here also you can observe the presence of honeydew, which will attract the black sooty mold, which in turn attract the ants. So next is next symptom is unopened flowers, which often shrivel and later die. Then you can also observe small deformed fruits. Though the plant becomes stunted, an eventual drying of the plants will be observed. So next is the biology of the insect. Here the nymphs and adults both will suck the sap, and both will have soft-bodied insect, and they are covered by a mass of mealy white waxy covering over the body. And this egg, they will overwinter on stem, soil, cracks, and also surfaces of the stem, and also inside the crumpled leaves. Then the female will lay fresh eggs of about 500 to 600, which are orange in color, but later they will turn into pinkish just prior to hatching. Then the crawlers, they will disperse from the ovisac of the adult by way of walking or by wind or by ants. Then the nymphs will develop into adults in about 30 days. And the life cycle, it will complete for about 45 days, it will complete. Then there will be 10 to 15 generation per year. That is, it is multi-volatile insect. So next is the management. For management, we have to first monitor the incident regularly and have to look for the crawler emergence. In order to get maximum control, we have to take up the management at initial stage itself. So wherever necessary, you have to use neem-based botanical insecticides such as neem oil, NSKE, or fish oil, rosin soap, like that. Then you have to use release N-citrate, parasitoid, Acerophagus papai at 100 per number against the Phenococcus solanopsis. Then you can also use chemical control with dimethoate or propinophos at 2 ml per liter. So next is another important pest, which is also a borer. So it is a pink bollworm. The scientific name is Pectinophora gossypiella. It comes under the family Gelichidae and order Lepidoptera. So besides cotton, it also feed on bendy, hollyhock, mesta, abutilon indicum, hibiscus, and also many other malvaceous crops. And once the plant is infected, you can observe rosetted flowers. And rosetted flowers mean two flowers which are joined together. Then the excreta will also be observed at the point of bore holes by larval feeding. So when the bores are opened, you can observe damaged seed kernel. Then you can also observe double seed. Double seed is nothing but they will cut the window hole or interlocular burrowing in the two adjoining seeds. Thereby, they will form this double seed. And they also attack buds. And you can observe immature balls drop off. Then the lint is destroyed completely with the discolored lint and borrowed seed. Next is the biology of the insect. The adult is a small dark brown moth, and it lays flattened and striated eggs on the balls or in between bract or on the buds and flowers. On an average, it can lay up to 125 eggs in its lifetime. Then the egg period, it varies from 4 to 25 days. So once the larvae emerges, it will be pinkish in color with dark brown head. And they will be having a prothoracic sheath that becomes fully grown. The larvae will become fully grown in 25 to 35 days. And it will pupate in a thin silken cocoon among the lint. Then inside a seed or in double seeds, in between bracts or anywhere it can pupate. And also it will pupate in cracks in the soil. And the pupal period will be about 6 to 20 days. And another peculiar character is that it will undergo hibernation during larval stage. And the hibernation is observed only in North India, because in North India, the temperature will go so low. So they will undergo hibernation, whereas in South India, it is not reported till now. So next is the management of this pest. So the ETL is 10% infested rosette flowers. So you have to go through all this management. First is the clean cultivation and destruction of crop residue before the onset of season. Then you have to plow very deeply in order to expose the hibernating larva or pupa in the soil. Then you have to avoid the late sowing. You can go for tolerant varieties like Kanwa 2, Abadita, LH900, then Sujai Desi cotton. You can also set up pheromone traps which will monitor the adult moth activity. Then as usual, you have to keep the field free of weeds. Then you have to monitor the moth through field scouting and also pheromone trap. And the pheromone used is gossip lure. Then you have to destroy the pink boll worm in rosette flowers, and you have to periodically remove and destroy the dropped flowers because it will also contain the larvae. So you have to remove it. Then you have to remove the dried flowers and also the premature balls. Then the ratooning should be avoided. So after final picking, you have to allow the cattle, sheep or goats to graze upon immature green balls in order to prevent the carryover of this pest to the next season. And also you have to destroy the cotton stubbles in order to prevent the carryover to the next season. And next is you can apply bacterial formulation, that is Bacillus thuringiensis costecki. It is one of the effective bacterial formulation that is used till now. You might have heard about the transgenic plant, that is BT cotton. Besides BT cotton, you can also spray this bacterial formulation at 1 kg per hectare. Then you can go for the release of egg parasitoid, that is Trichogramma at 1 lakh per hectare, which will coincide the incidence of the pest. So the release and the pest coincidence should always synchronize. Then you have to dust the field with carbaryl 5% at 20 kg per hectare. Then in order to control, you can go for any one of the following pesticide for spraying. Then you have to use acid delinted seed. So you might have studied in agronomy about the acid delinting. Then you have to use only recommended dose of nitrogen. You should never use a high rate of this nitrogen because it will attract, and also the crop will become susceptible to the pest. And then you have to restrict the movement of the cotton seed from other areas of stick. You should never move, or you can market the cotton seeds from one state to another. If at all you are in an idea to move, means you have to go for seed fumigation with aluminium phosphide, like quick phos, phosphume, phosphotoxin at 50 tablet per 1000 cubic feet. And also need-based, you should use only need-based insecticide. In particular, persistent insecticide like quinolphos, chlorpyrifos, it is going to be banned now. So you cannot use it further. And also in severe incident, you can go for cypermethrin, then lambda cyhalothrin or thiodicarb on need basis towards the end of crop season. So next best is the American bollworm. You know that it is a polyphagous pest, and it invests gram, lab, safflower, shinleaf, groundnut, tobacco, tomato and so on. So it will feed on the leaves initially, and later it will bore into the square or bowls, and the seed with its head, it will thrust its head inside the bore hole, and the rest of the body will be outside the ball. And the entry hole will also be very large and circular at the base of the ball. You can also observe flat or open squares. Then the bowls will be bored at the base of flower bed. Buds which are hollowed out, and the bracts of damaged flower buds will spread out and curl downwards. As a result, there will be premature ball opening and also the shedding of the balls. So next is the biology of... Sir?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Hello?
Ma'am?
Anything you need to ask?
Yes, ma'am. This flared up squares is a symptom of this spotted bollworm, also, no, ma'am.
Excuse me, I can't hear you.
This flared up squares is a symptom of spotted bollworm, also, no, ma'am.
Actually, I can hear you properly. Can you increase your volume?
Yes.
Or can you message me?
Ma'am.
Oh, yeah.
These flared up squares are a symptom of the spotted bollworm also, no, ma'am. Previous slide.
Previous slide?
Yes, ma'am. Here, fair.
I mean, in American bollworm, it is the major symptom, flared or open squares. You are asking whether it is seen in spotted bollworm also?
Yes, ma'am. I have read somewhere that is for that also. In this also, that condition will appear, ma'am?
Yeah, in mostly in American bollworm only it is seen.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. I will come to that pest next, okay?
Oh.
But flat or open square, if they ask me, you have to write in this American bollworm.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Shall I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is the biology of the insect. So here the moth, it is stout, medium size with brownish or grayish wovings with a dark cross band which will be near the outer margin, and you can also observe dark spot near coastal margins too. And they will lay spherical yellowish eggs which are laid singly on tender parts and butts of plants, and the egg period will last for about 2 to 4 days. The caterpillar will be of varying color. Initially, it will be brown. Then later, it will turn finished with darker brown lines along the side of the body. And also, the larval period, it lasts for about 18 to 25 days. The body will be covered with radiating hairs. Then when it is fully grown, they will measure for about 3.7 to 5 centimeters. Then the fully grown caterpillar, it will pupate in the soil in an earthen cell, and the adult will emerge within 16 to 21 days. So next is the management strategy. So here you have to destroy or distract the crop residue that are present in the field. Then you have to handpick the grown larva and you have to destroy it. Then you can also go for intercrops such as cowpea, onion, maize, coriander and wood bean at the rate of 1:2 ratio. Then as guard crop, you can also grow sorghum or maize in 4 rows all around the cotton crop. Then ovipositional trap crops are also being used, that is the marigold, which is about 100 plants per acre. Then you have to collect the larva from the Then you have to also erect the bird perches, which will be T in shape for encouraging the predatory birds, which will feed on the larvae such as king crow, myna, then drongo. Then the growing of early maturing and tolerant varieties such as Abadija, LK861, NA1280 and G. Also, you have to install the pheromone traps in order to trap the moth. So it will be like you have to set up for about 4 per acre. Then you can also go for application of nuclear polyhedral virus. So it is an entomopathogenic virus. You can go, you can spray off at the rate of 3 × 10^12 POB per hectare. So in evening hours at 7th and 12th week after sowing. Then you can also spray baseless thuringiensis coxsackii at the rate of 750 to 1000 gram per hectare. You can also go for the spraying of entomopathogenic fungi, at the, that is Bivaria baseana, at the rate of 400 gram per hectare. Then you have to release egg parasitoid, that is Trichogramma species, at 6.25 cc. So 1 cc it will contain 15 to 20,000 eggs per hectare at 15 days interval, 3 times from 45 days after sowing. Then you have to go for the release of egg larval parasitoid like Chelonis blackburni, and you can also release predator Chrysoberla carnea at 1 lakh per hectare at 6th, 13th and 14th week after sowing. Then after that you have to go for spraying at early stage of square formation, any one of the insecticide you can use. Then during balling and maturation stage, you have to use again other insecticide like quinol force, carbaryl and pyrachlorophos. So the next best it is the spotted bollworm. It is Arias vitella or Arias insulina. So as she said, here also flaring up is seen, but mostly here they will be boring into the ball. It will be irregular in shape, but flaring up is mostly seen in American bollworm only. They will also form flaring up of bract, but it will be not very much destructive. So they will feed on bending, hollyhock, hibiscus, cannabinus, and abutilon. So here mainly the drying and drooping of the terminal shoots, it will take place, and also they will form poles on balls, and the balls will consequently it will rot. So the shedding of squares and egg balls also is seen in the spotted bollworm. So next we can go on to the biology. So here, as I said, there are two species, that is Arias vitella and Arias insulina. So these eggs, they will lay eggs which will stay up to 2 to 10 days. Then emerges a larva which will be brownish with white streak dorsally. It is a peculiar character of this larvae, that is, it will be having white streaks and pale yellow ventrally, and also they will be having finger shaped processes. So next is the caterpillar. Both the species will be having a number of black and brown spot on their body, and the larval stage will last about 9 to 25 days. Then after that, the pupation will start. So it will take place in fallen material or outside the ball on plant surfaces and in cracks and crevices of the soil. So the pupa will be like a brown and board shape. Then the adult will be small buff colored. The moth will be buff colored, and the main difference between this insulina and vitella is that in the forming. So here in vitella they will be having a white band, whereas for insulina the forewing will be completely green. And the female moth, they will lay spherical, and also here you can see the eggs are structured bluish eggs, and they will lay singly or in groups on tender parts of the plant. Then they will also lay these eggs on fresh leaves, fresh squares and flowers. On an average, it can lay up to 60 to 80 eggs. So next we will move on to the management strategy. So first, as in any other pest, you have to destroy the plants which is affected by this pest. You have to destroy the crop residue, and also you have to go for remove the alternative weed host. So and then you have to collect and destroy the infested shoots, squares and balls in the fallen material. Then you have to adopt the crop rotation. You should not adopt monocropping. As you know, monocropping will encourage the pest infestation more. Then you have to go for deep plowing in summer. Then you can also go for intercultivation with sorghum, green gram, cluster bean and jowar. Then you have to set up a pheromone trap in order to trap the moth at 12 per hectare. Then you have to conserve. And also you have to use the natural enemies like Trichogramma evanescens, Brecon lefroy, Brecon habitor, Brecon breviconis, Aphelentus, Hilesmus species, which will parasite the larval stage. And also you can use Chelonis and Chalcis species that will parasite the pupal stage. Then you have to release the first instar larvae of Chrysoperla species at 1 lakh per hectare. So they may ask the rate of this Chrysoperla release. Then you have to go for a foliar spray with Bacillus thuringiensis at 2 gram per liter of water. Then in order to control the pest, you can go for spraying insecticide. So you can use any one of the following insecticide over here. Then biological control, you have to spray Bacillus thuringiensis var prusteki at the rate of 750 to 1000 gram per hectare. Then you have to, then the next pest is the tobacco caterpillar. So it can also feed on castor, groundnut, tomato, cabbage, and various other cruciferous crops. You might have heard about Spodoptera litura. It is also a very serious pest. The insect can damage, can cause the following damage, like scrapping the epidermal layer, leaving the skeleton of veins of leaf. Then during severe attack, only the stem and the side shoot will be standing in the field without any leaf or bone. They will completely defoliate the leaves. And also the larva feed the leaves by making small holes, which will increase. And you can also observe irregular holes on leaves initially, and later complete skeletonization of the leaves will take place. As I said, it is a defoliator, and there will be presence of bore holes too. Bore balls too. So next is the biology of the insect. So,
ma'am?
Ma'am, since it is a defoliate, heavy defoliation occurs, can it come under defoliators?
It is actually tobacco caterpillar comes under defoliation and defoliator, because it will skeletonize as well as it will eat the whole, it will damage the whole plant by feeding on the leaf.
Okay, ma'am.
It is the, defoliation is their major job. That's what. Okay.
Okay.
So next is the biology of the insect. So the moth, it will be laying eggs in mass which appear golden brown in color, and the larva will be pale greenish with dark markings, and also they are gregarious in the earlier stages, and the egg will be covered with brown hairs, and they will hatch within 3 to 5 days. The caterpillar, it will measure up to 35 to 40 mm in length. And also, it is velvety, black with yellowish green dorsal stripes. So it is a peculiar character. It will be having a dorsal stripe and lateral white bands with incomplete ring. So we can also observe this incomplete ring-like dark band on anterior and also on the posterior end of the body. And also they will be having 6 instars, and the larval stage will last up to 15 to 30 days. And then the pupation. The pupation will take place inside the soil, and it will last for about 7 to 15 days. Then after that, the moth emerges. It will be like medium sized, and the body will be stout with four wings. So here you can observe the moth, their four wings. It is pale gray to dark brown in color, and also they will be having wavy white crisscross markings. So hind wings will be whitish with brown patches along the margin of wings. And the pest, it will breed throughout the year. And since they come under Noctidae, they will be more active at night. And the female will lay about 300 eggs in cluster. And the adult live for about 7 to 10 days. And the total life cycle it takes is about 30 to 60 days. It is also a multi-volatile insect. That is, there will be 8 generation per year. So next is the management. The ETL will be like 1 egg mass per 10 plants. So when you take 10 plants, there should be at least 1 egg mass. So the following management strategies are followed. First is to collect and to distract the infested material from the field. Then you have to pluck the leaves that harbor this egg masses or gregarious larvae, and you have to destroy it. Then you have to set up a light trap in order to attract the moth. And also you have to keep the pheromone trap at 12 per hectare. Then you can go for botanical insecticide spray against egg and first instar larvae. Then you can go for NPV at 200 larval equivalent per acre in combination with jaggery, 1 kg sandowit 100 ml, or robin do 50 gram thrice at 10 to 15 days interval. Once you observe the eggs of first instar larvae in the evening hours, you have to go for the spray of NPV. So next is you have to release egg parasitoid, that is trichogramma, at 50,000 per hectare per week 4 times. Then you have to go for foliar spray. So endosulfan, it is being already banned. So you have to go for chlorantraniprole and difluobenzurone. Then spraying of insecticide should be done either early in the morning or early in or late in the evening. And the spraying of virus should be done in the evening only. Then you have to go for poison bait pellets, which is prepared with rice bran, jaggery, carbaryl, and along with water. So this bait, it can spread in the field in the evening hours, so that the caterpillar will come out of the soil and they will feed and they will get killed. So next, you can also go for NPV spray at the rate of 1.5 into 10 raised to 12 POB per hectare. So next is the cotton, red cotton bug. You might have heard this pest, but it is also a minor pest in the cotton. So the scientific name is Disdergus cingulatus, which comes under the family Firhoporidae and order Hemiptera. And it also feeds on bendy, maize, and mesta. So the damage symptom here, you can observe red stained link, and also you can observe rotting balls. And also the inner ball will be having warty growth or water soaked spots, you can observe. So the young balls that are produced will abort and it will turn into dark brown in color. So the bacterium, it is a Nematospora gossypii bacterium, it will enter the site of injury and this will stain the fiber and the lint will be discolored. And here the nymphs and adults both will be reddish bugs with white bands on the abdomen, and you can also observe black markings on the wings. So in order to manage, you can use the predator Herpactor postalis. It is also a bug, redwick bug. Then you can go for dusting of methyl parathion or carbaryl at 10 to 12 kg per acre, which are very much effective against this pest. Then you can go for plowing the field in order to expose the eggs, which will later be predated by birds or any other predators. Then you have to go for spraying phosphomidone at 600 ml per hectare. So these are not very important pests, but you should. But these are also pests that you should know, because they will ask for a scientific name or a family in the exams. So next is the dusky cotton bug. It is Oxycarinus hyalinipellis that comes under the family Lygidae and order Hemiptera. It also feeds on lady's finger, gogu, Abitolon indicum, and hollyhock. So once this pest damaged the crop, you can you can observe that the lint will be black in color and the seeds will also be discolored and it will shrunk. So the biology of the insect is that they will lay a cigar-shaped egg, which will be white in color, and they will also, this particular bug also lay the egg in cluster of 2 to 10 within the half open balls. It will also lay the eggs on balls, flowers or buds. Then the nymphs and adults, it will be dusky grayish brown bug with a pointed head, and the wings will be hyaline. So next is the management. So you can release the anthochorid bug Aureus dantilus on the nymphs. It is a predator. Then you can also dust methyl parathion or carbaryl, which is also found to be effective against this pest. Next is the cotton stem weevil, Pampurellus affinis, which comes under the family Curculionidae and the order Coleoptera. So these are known to affect Corchorus olitorius. It is actually a jute fiber, then Abitolon species, Hibiscus rosacainensis, then Hibiscus cannabinus, Hibiscus viticolius, and also Althea roseate. So the damage symptom of this particular pest is that you can observe the swelling on the stem just above the ground level. So you can observe here there is swelling. And the older plants that are meant to survive will lack vigor and also strength. So once the wind is blown, the nodes will break and the stem will fall down. So next is the biology of the pest. So the female will lay oval globular smooth milky white eggs, which will last for a period of about 6 to 10 days. The grubs that emerge will be like white in color without leg. That without leg is termed as epodous larvae. And the period will last for about 35 to 37 days. The larvae will be very small weevil and it will be dark in color with two small white patches. In elytra, you can observe white patches. Then it will pupate in the stem itself and emerge as adults in about 25 to 30 days. So on an average, a single female can lay about 50 eggs. On a single stem, it can lay about 7 to 8 eggs. So next is the management practice. So you can go for removal and destruction of attack plant. So this is a uterus wasp, which is seen to be parasitic on this cotton stem weevil. Then next is the basal application of farmyard manure at 25 tons per hectare. And also you can apply neem cake at the rate of 250 kg per hectare. You can also go for seed treatment with the chlorpyrifos. Okay, now you can't use, but in most of the websites, it has given this particular website only. Soon they will also be banned. And next is the spray any one of the following insecticide like carbaryl or carbofuron against the grubs. So next is the cotton leaf roller. So the scientific name is Scilepta derogata. It comes under the family Crambidae and order Lepidoptera. So it is one of the sporadic pests of cotton in India. So they may ask this question. This is an important point that you have to remember in this cotton leaf roller. It also affects bendi and several other malvaceous plants. And once this pest infests the crop, you can see the larvae will roll the leaf and it will feed inside this roll. And they will feed the green tissue in the early stage and eats up a large portion of the leaf. So during severe infestation, large number of leaves will be rolled and the plants and the leaves will be rolled in the form of trumpets. So trumpet is an instrument, so you can see trumpet like leaves when this pest attack this crop in a severe rate. And also it will produce silken threads, and the marginal portion of the leaves will be eaten away and the plants will be completely defoliated. So the biology of this pest is that the egg will be very smooth and flat. It will be pale white in color and it will last for about 2 to 3 days. And once the larva emerges, it will be bright green in color and also the body will be glistening with dark head. And also you can observe the prothoracic sheath. And the larval period, it will last for about 15 to 18 days. Then it goes for pupation. So the pupation will also be taken place inside the leaf roll and it will last about 7 to 8 days. So this adult moth, they will be having yellow wings and also there will be brown wavy marking all over the body. So next is the management practice. So you have to collect and you have to destroy the shedded plant part that is affected by this leaf folder. Then you have to hand pick and destroy the grown up caterpillar just like in ball worms. Then you have to go for release of natural enemies like Trichogramma species, then this Brachymeria, then Elasmus indicus, Aphantilus, then Brecon leproi. These all are egg parasites that you can release in the field. Then other pupal parasitoid like Trichospilus pupivora and Tandopimpla species can also be released. Then you have to go for foliar spraying with carbaryl, monocrotophus, which are also effective against this pest. Then you can also use dichlorobos and phenytrothione. So next is the shoot weevil. It is also a very minor pest in cotton. So shoot weevil, it is a scientific name is Alcedos afeba. It also comes under the family Curculionidae and order Coleoptera. And it will affect gogo and lady's finger mainly. Then the symptom that it causes on the crop is that the terminal shoot will be having gall-like formation. Then it will also bore holes surrounded by raised margin. Next is the identification of the pest. So here you can see it is a weevil which is dark grayish brown in color, and also they will be having cross bands on the elytra. Then for management, you can go for soil application of carbofuran. It may be done on 20 days after sowing and earthing up. Then you can also go for basal application of farmyard manure, like 25 tons per hectare, or you can go for neem cake application, 250 kg per hectare. So next is the ash weevil. It is also a defoliator. The scientific name is Myloceres and Decem pustulatus. The host plant that it depends on is red gram, bajra, ragi, sorghum, maize, gobu, lady's finger, and sugarcane. So this pest you can see very, very much in the cotton field. So the damage symptom it causes is the leaf margins will be notched. Then you can see the plants will be wilted in patches in the field. So once you pull off the plant, it will come off very easily. And the roots will also be eaten away by the grubs. The grubs will feed on the root, and the adult will be feeding on the leaves. So next is the biology of this particular insect. So the female will lay an egg which will be light yellowish oval in color. It will be laid in the soil, and the eggs, it can lay up to 361 eggs in its lifetime, and the egg period will be about 3 to 11 days. And the grub, it will be small and it white apodous grub, that is, it will not be having any legs. And the grubs, it will pupate in the earthen cell, it will also pupate in the soil, and it will also lay eggs in the soil. And the adult, which will be grayish white, white in color, which is having white elytra, and also it will be having dark lines on the elytra. And the total life cycle will take about 42 to 54 days. So next is the management. You just have to go for removal of the affected branches or plants. Then you can also spray Quinalfos or Chlorpyrifos. So,
excuse me.
Yes, hello.
Previous slide, the management, why should we break the branches, ma'am?
What?
This is management, first one, removal of affected branches or plants is there, no, ma'am?
Yeah, I mean the grubs will be there, no?
You so two grubs will feed in on the roots, no, ma'am?
It will feed on the roots, and it will also feed on the leaves also.
Okay.
But it will especially feed on the root. But adult will feed only on the leaf, whereas the grubs can leave both. I mean,
adults can fly, no, ma'am?
Yeah, it can fly. It is having elytra, no? It can fly.
Then if they fly, then why to destroy
adult
the branches?
No. I saw the grub will be.
Okay.
The grubs will be, gathered around the branches. So we have to remove it. It will be sluggish.
Apodous, no? That's right.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
It is not having elytra, no. It will be apodous, so it can be removed. Yes.
And in this cotton.
Cotton?
Red cotton bug is there, no, ma'am?
Yeah.
In that, staining of lint is due to that bug excreta, ma'am?
First the red cotton bug will affect the seed, then again the bacterium is there, no? Nematospora
gossypii.
That is the one which will make the lint discolored.
Stain. And in dusky cotton bug, ma'am?
Dusky cotton bug, the adult itself will make the lint discolored. There will be
that
no,
will that will make
no
the lint black.
Or any other, I can't hear you.
That will make the lint black, ma'am.
Black color lint you can observe.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, where is the site of pupation for this thrips, ma'am? First you told cotton thrips.
Under the leaves. Under the leaves. Thrips will be having pupa.
Yes, ma'am.
It
under
is
the leaves, ma'am.
Pseudopupa, ma'am. It is not holometabolish. Thrips. They will be having incomplete metamorphosis, no? Hemiptera?
Yes, ma'am.
Then what is the pseudo pupa, ma'am?
Huh?
What is the pseudo pupa, ma'am?
Pseudo pupa means it will be a stage between the adult and the grub. That is, the stage will be like they won't move. It is considered a pseudo pupa.
Okay, ma'am.
But they will not form real pupa.
Okay, ma'am.
Stage between the immature and the adult, in between.
Nymph and the adult.
Ah, yes.
Okay, ma'am.
So you should know the scientific name, family, then which all are the vectors, which all are transmitting the virus. You should know the virus also. Okay. Then particular symptoms you should be aware of. Then management strategy also you have to learn. For IBPS, they will be asking mostly scientific names, family. It will be very simple. They won't be asking anything so deeply. So you just have to go through it. You just understand. That is enough. They will never ask anything deeply.
Parasitoids, predators, they won't ask, ma'am.
Parasitoid and predators means they may ask like Trichogramma chylonis, at what rate they will be released. They may ask.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, like that they may ask. Because for a single pest itself, we will be using many parasitoids now. So they can't ask specifically. For example, for papaya mealybug, they may ask. Because Acerophagus papaya specific, which is being exported. I mean imported. I'm sorry.
Ma'am, today poll is there, ma'am.
What?
Poll.
Poll is there. Question to cert. So, shall I ask you some questions?
Yes, ma'am.
So you can. Okay. One second. Shall I ask? You can even type the answer, or you can unmute and you can say the answer. Okay. Okay.
Yes. Hello? Yes.
Okay. So in cotton, gall-like swelling near the collar region is caused by
stem weevil, Pampurilus affinis.
Okay. Then marginal downward curling of cotton leaves is characteristic symptom of white fly, leaf hopper, ball worm, and the red cotton bug. Downward curling. Hello?
Leaf hopper, ma'am.
So next